Loxone enthusiasts, would you like to see a step-by-step walkthrough building not only one, but two Loxone control panels? Because if you are, you're in the right place. Let me show you a quick preview.
Extra low voltage, 24 volt DC power supplies. Well, I'll do that first. There's a mini server and...
Now, I do need to make you aware of something before we start this video. So these two panels that you're about to see me build were probably the third or fourth set of Loxone panels I ever built and was filmed about 3 years ago. So the quality might be a little bit worse than the panels that you see me build today. Also, this is one of Ix's projects who I was subcontracting for at the time, so can't take any credit for the design or panel layout. And one final thing before you will crucify me, my terminology is a little bit off on a couple of occasions, so I've corrected myself using text pop-ups on the times that this does happen.
So the first bit I'm going to start on is going to be the extra low voltage 24 volt DC stuff. So let me show you that now. So this panel was built earlier, and you can see here that out of the two 10 amp lambda 24 volt DC power supplies, obviously the mains is going in there and then being converted. Obviously black's going down to the neutral bar, and then the direct 24 volt DC is coming out of there into 10 amp fuse, and then going across here into this lovely terminal block, 8-way direct terminal block. So basically whatever goes in here goes directly through and then out the other side. So perfect for cat cable and of course Loxone tree cable.
So I just want to do a quick cutaway and explain this bit here. So when I did this 3 years ago and posted a couple of photos on Instagram, people were saying that those grey terminal blocks, they're all interconnected. So it will end up all shorting out the 24 volts from the tree and it would have been an absolute mess. And that is true. But what they didn't realise is on this panel, we'd actually removed all the interconnecting bridges that are usually in those grey terminal blocks. So they're acting like the blue terminal blocks, which you can see here. So yeah, just thought I'd point that out just in case you're thinking the same thing whilst I'm building this panel.
So that's what I'm going to do first. As you can see here, I'm just going to do the 10 amp 24 volt and ground. And then what I'm going to do, I'll do that first and then I'll come back. So yeah, so doing two panels here, and as you can see, there's less outbound cables on this panel. So yeah, just gonna be half the amount on these two.
So hopefully you can see that and I'm not shaking too much. But as you can see, all you need to do with these is just insert the strip back cable. I need to do that properly, but insert that strip back cable straight into there. And then you see that little push button above it, you just push that down with the end of a screwdriver, slide straight in. No faffing about with having to screw down terminal blocks, just really nice and easy, straight in, and obviously reduces the time of the panel, or the wiring of the panel, significantly.
So that's the higher output power supplies wired. And I didn't explain what they're actually for. So those bigger power supplies, the 10 amp power supplies, are for lighting really, on the tree bus. So Loxone RGBW downlights, the ceiling lights, potentially LED tape, and also the pendulum slims. So let me just quickly show you the wiring thus far for that.
Yep, so that's out of the power supplies.
Another little cutaway, guys. You see those fuse connector holders next to the 10 amp power supplies? One made a schoolboy error, which caused us probably, I don't know, half an hour, 20, it would be much longer if it wasn't for Michael from Ixa helping, who was the one that discovered this problem. But if you wait till the end of the video, I'll explain what happened and something to watch out for so you don't make the same mistake.
Yep, so that's out of the power supplies into 10 amp fuse. And then you can see going along to these lovely terminal blocks by Wildmüller. And then that's gonna basically, that's going straight through there. And then the orange, the thicker orange white is going on the other end there, out to whatever's on that bus. So there you go. And the grounds are all being commoned up down here.
So the next bit I'm gonna do is, again, 24 volts DC, the smaller power supplies with smaller output. I think they're 1.4 or 0.6 amp power supplies. And this is gonna be the power for, one, the peripherals. So motion sensors, Loxone touch switches, valve actuators. So that's going to be on one power supply. Recommended that the power supplies are split. So lighting, peripherals. So we've done the lighting, now we're going to do the peripherals and then also control. So 24 volts that powers the mini server and the extensions attached to it. So we're going to do both those second, smaller power supplies now. Let's do it.
Okay, so that's the 24 volts, smaller power supply, 1.4 amps wired for the controls. So let me show you that.
So yeah, the controls being the mini server, the relay extension times two, the airbase, and also the tree extension. So what done here? Come out the the first 1.5 amp power supply into the mini server, and then out the outbound terminals of the mini server. Because what you can do here, if you get this round the right way, you can actually send a web command to the mini server that will actually power cycle all the extensions connected to it. So that's the left side's inbound for 24 volt and ground, and then the right side is outbound. And these new terminal blocks, or pushing connectors, sorry, work really well with FS cable. Really, really nice. Just speeds things up hugely. But yeah, as you can see, just going along. And then from the airbase down to the tree extension. And then I've just, again, commoned up the power supplies going over here.
So next bit is the other 1.4 amp power supply. And that's gonna be used for the peripherals. So the motion sensors, the valve actuators, touch pures, touches, etc., room comfort sensors. So that's going to be coming out of 1.4 amp power supply over to this terminal block, and basically just bussing that 24 volts along, and then the tree cable can go out of there.
So that's the power for the peripherals, the motion sensors, switches, room comfort sensors, and valve actuators. That's all wired from this one here. So 1.4 amp power supply going up there and going into the first connection, and then just bussing along. So there'd be four cables going out of that.
So the next bit is the tree communications out of the tree extension. So two branches, 50 on each branch. So one branch is gonna go to one connector block and be bussed across, and then the other branch is going to the other connector block being bussed across. So yeah, we can have up to 50 devices on each branch. Devices being tree lights, tree switches, tree motion sensors, tree valve actuators, pretty much anything tree is connected.
So yeah, that's the tree extension done. Very simple, left branch, right branch, 50 devices per branch. So both coming up here, first cables going into the left terminal block number one, and then just bust across to two. So basically, well, you could actually have four cables on those two blocks because these connectors are just sort of bust across. So anyway, basically you can have two cables on one branch, two to four cables on one branch, and then two to four cables on the second branch.
So the next bit is the link connection, and that's the communication from the mini server or communication back from extensions to the mini server. So yeah, it's basically the communication between the mini server and the extensions, and the extensions back to the mini server. So let's do that now.
So that is the link connection done. As you can see here, the blue terminals on the mini server. So that's just being connected to each extension. So you can see blue and white, blue and white, blue and white, and then that's not the last one there. So from the airbase back down the trunking and into the last extension here, and you can see that there's a 120 ohm resistor in there. So that is basically the communication between the mini server and the extensions all done.
So that's all the low voltage and communication cabling done. And the next bit now is to do the 230 volt mains, basically all relays. So all being switched through the relays on the mini server and the relay extensions. So mini server relays 5 amp and the relay extensions are 16 amps.
Guys, if you're enjoying this, would you mind giving us a like? Just helps get the video out to more people.
20 exactly. So here down the bottom, these are all the relays for the mini server. You can see those first four being used as just volt free. And then we've got the next lot here. You've got a mains feed looping through. And then when the relay closes, it just switches that 230 volt mains either to, most likely here actually a lighting load because they're 5 amp relays. And then on the relay extensions, you can just see it's all exactly the same, just 230 volt supply, and then the relays are just switching. So those could be higher loads as those relays are 16 amps. So yeah, so you can see then they all go back to the terminal block. So quite a time consuming bit that was, but all done now. The only thing missing is the feed. So that will go into that first relay and then a cable off to the breaker.
So just to run through with you guys what I mentioned earlier about that problem with the fuse connectors and the power supplies. So if I remember correctly, what was happening was is we were getting a 230 volt supply going to the power supplies, but we weren't getting anything on the 24 volt DC outbound side. And it took, well, I can work it out at the time. It took Michael probably only 10 minutes to work it out. But what it was, schoolboy error on my part, I haven't put a end plate connector on the side of that fuse holder that was next to the metal casing of that power supply. So what was happening was the internal connectors or the internal metal terminals within that fuse holder were shorting against that metal casing, which was shorting out the power supply. And because those power supplies have got overcurrent protection or short circuit protection built in, they just switch off as soon as they detect that. So yeah, hopefully you guys won't make the same problem. And if it wasn't for Michael at ICSA, probably still be there now trying to fault find that issue. If you'd like to watch a more recent Loxone control panel, check out this video here. And if you'd like to watch a BMS KNX panel build, check out this video here.